level the mountain.
Hallelujah.
Whatever trouble we're going through this morning, he's going to level those mountains.
Hallelujah.
And I will break down the gates of bronze, and I will cut through the bars of iron.
Hallelujah.
And I will give you treasures of darkness, the riches stored in secret places, that you may know that I am the Lord, the God of Israel, who summons you by name this morning. Hallelujah. He knows your very name this morning. Hallelujah. He is a God that will see you through anything. Hallelujah. When you put your trust and faith in him. Let's worship the Lord this morning and give our God the greatest glory of all. Amen. Forward.
Well, hallelujah. Are you happy in the Lord this morning? Can you give the Lord some praise? Hallelujah. He said, as the worship and the glory praises go up, the glory comes down. Amen. And in that glory this morning comes freedom, comes healing, comes whatever you have need of. Well, I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. Well, I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. Can you sing that chorus? I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm gonna sing. I'm gonna sing for you. Like nobody's listening, and nobody's listening, sing for you, my Lord. I'm gonna sing for you. Like nobody's listening, and nobody's listening, sing for you, my Lord. But we're not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. We worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed. We shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed. We worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed. We shout out the name of my Lord. Well, I'm gonna dance the victory.
I'm gonna dance for you. Like nobody's watching, and nobody's watching me. Dance for you, my Lord.
Oh, you've been so good.
I'm gonna dance for you. Like nobody's watching, and nobody's watching. Dance for you, my Lord.
Cause we're not ashamed.
I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord.
I'm gonna sing this morning.
I'm gonna sing for you. Like nobody's listening, and nobody's listening. Sing for you, my Lord. I'm gonna sing for you. Like nobody's listening, and nobody's listening. Sing for you, my Lord.
Cause we're not ashamed.
I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord.
say, I'm going to sing. Pull it down.
I'm going to sing for you.
Come on, sing.
Like nobody's listening and nobody's listening. Sing for you, my Lord.
Can we hear you sing that this morning?
I'm going to sing for you.
Like nobody's listening.
Like nobody's listening. Nobody's listening. Sing for you, my Lord.
Oh, you sound so beautiful, church. I'm going to sing.
I'm going to sing for you. Like nobody's listening. Nobody's listening. Sing for you, my Lord.
We're not ashamed.
I'm not ashamed. To worship the name of Jesus, Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to worship the name of Jesus, Jesus. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord.
Shout.
I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord. I'm not ashamed to shout out the name of my Lord.
Come to sing about freedom this morning, amen. If you're free in the Lord, can you give us some praise? Lord, keep your hands together this morning. We are victorious people in Jesus' name.
Oh, 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 oh. I
shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah.
We'll sing about freedom. Freedom.
Oh, freedom.
Sing it out, freedom.
Say freedom. Freedom.
So glad we're free.
Oh, freedom. Freedom.
Lord, you've been so good. Through the blood of Jesus Christ that you're free today. Can you give the Lord some praise? Oh, hallelujah. Because it's his blood that changes. It's his blood that restores, refreshes, and renews. Amen? Worship with Sister Corinne as she comes.
A rescue in my sin-stained life. Your blood is healing to the hopeless and broken. Your blood is enough. Jesus is enough. And your blood is a shelter in the middle of my storm. Your blood is my refuge when I'm hurting and alone. Your blood is enough. Jesus is enough. It's renewing, restoring, saving and healing, delivering. It is life everlasting to all who receive it. Your blood, it's more than enough. It's more than enough. And your blood is a rescue in my sin-stained life. Your blood is healing to the hopeless and broken. Your blood is enough. Jesus is enough. And your blood is a shelter in the middle of my storm. And your blood is my refuge when I'm hurting and alone. Your blood is enough. Jesus is enough. Everlasting to all who receive it. Your blood, it's more than enough. It's more than enough. It's more than enough.
Said if you know that blood is more than enough. I said if you know that your God is more than enough. Can you stand your feet one more time this morning? If my God is more than enough, He can supply all my need. He is my El Shaddai, the all-will.
is the child for me, the overcomer. He is my God.
Is he your God this morning?
My God is more than enough. He can supply all my need. He is my El Shaddai. He always looks out for me. Jehovah Jireh. He is my God.
Why should we worry, church? Say,
why should I worry about the highs and the lows, the ups and the downs? When by my faith I know my God is more than enough. He can supply all my need. He is my El Shaddai. He always looks out for me. Jehovah Jireh, He is my God.
All the earth is His, can you say?
Well, all the earth is His, and the fullness thereof. Everything that I need, you can be sure of. Jehovah Jireh, He is my God.
Hallelujah, why should we worry, say?
Why should I worry about the highs and the lows, the ups and the downs? When by my faith I know my God is more than enough. He can supply all my need. He is my El Shaddai. He always looks out for me. Jehovah Jireh, He is my God.
Jehovah Jireh.
Jehovah Jireh, He is my God.
He's more than enough. He's more than enough. Yeah. Oh, give the Lord some praise. Well, I said, if He's been your everything in the midnight hour, if He's been your freedom. He said, I'm not giving you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. If you're thankful for that sound mind this morning, that others said you never have. But He's your God of restoration. He's your God of refreshing. He's your God of renewing. Can you give Him some praise this morning? Oh, He's been too good. Hallelujah. We always say this all the time. I ain't gonna let no rock cry out for me. As long as I got breath in my lungs, I'm gonna praise Him. As we said earlier, when the praises go up, the glory comes down. I'm ready for the glory, aren't you? I said I'm ready for the glory, aren't you? Well, give the Lord one more hand clap of praise as Brother Devin comes this morning.
Amen. How's everybody doing this morning? Amen. Man, they sang that song, no more shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. We are free. Amen. Come on, give God one more hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, we're going to start off with Pastor's word. It says, God does slumber or sleep, but His eyes are always watching. Thank God for watching over me. Amen. 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 Well, February 4th, we have coffee break here at the church. It'll be at 9 o'clock, so it's for all the women. Come in so they can grow stronger in the Lord, and amen. So they'll be doing Bible study and getting to know each other a little bit more, amen? Amen. Amen. All right, we also have our Refresh t-shirts. So they put an order, or they're going to put an order in today, but everybody has to turn in their money so they can get them bought and paid for, amen? So if you have an order, make sure you pay for it. If you haven't ordered yet, order them and then pay for them, amen? So... yeah, we can hit the refresh button on our life. Amen? Amen. 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 All right. Well, we got a testimony here about Andrew. I heard some good things about Andrew. Chad's going to tell about here in Jesus' name.
Well, see, he don't know that I'm going to tell this.
You see his eyes? He said, woo, what I do?
But see, what he don't know is me and Daddy are good friends.
Amen.
So we heard this news the other day, and I want to tell you how proud I am of this young man. He comes in, he puts his time in, amen, and he smiles all the time. Don't he look sharp today?
Yeah.
He dressed better than me. But you know, they told me something this week, and it really bubbled in my spirit because I was so proud of him. But you know, this man right here got the number one student at E. Hovey for this 9 weeks.
Yeah, amen. Come on. Come on. Amen.
So we are so proud of him. So ladies, he's not only good looking, but he's a genius.
Amen.
So watch out.
Amen.
Amen. We're proud of him.
Yeah, amen. Yeah, like Sister Nancy, he's single, so amen. So, amen. All right, Richard also had a testimony this morning. Yeah, amen. Come on. Yeah, amen. Amen. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, amen. Come on. Amen. Amen. That's our God. He's still in the healing business. Amen. Amen.
Hey, Brother Devin. Real quick, it just brought to my attention that God's favor is on the house again, because we not only had Andrew, but there's another student in here, Tyler Ryerson. Where you at?
Back on the wall.
There he is, back there. Don't he look nice today? But that fella back there also made honor roll this week, all A's. Amen?
Yeah,
so
amen.
We're proud of that in Jesus' name.
I might have to start hanging out with these guys. They're smarter than me. Woo. Amen. Well, Dia's also got one more testimony.
It's no. Oh, John? Luke, John's coming.
John's going to do it. Amen. Amen.
I get nervous when I get up here, but yesterday I got a phone call. My brother-in-law wasn't breathing in the CVS parking lot. So we got to praying and headed to Bellevue. Asked God not to take him. God saved him. When we got to the hospital, he was breathing. He was awake. God saved him. God saved him from hell. And he's here today. He's accepted Jesus as the Savior. Come up here, Lucas. My brother Lucas.
In case you were wondering what he meant by not breathing, he died. He was on his way to hell, and hell looked like they won. But I thank God for some Holy Ghost-filled folk that know how to get a hold of a living God that brought him back to life, that he got saved, that he didn't have to go to hell. Honey, hell is real, but you don't have to go. Somebody in here give God some praise.
Whoa. And not only that, that young man is so thankful to be alive today. Because he was about ready to split hell wide open. He accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as his Savior, and he's on his way to glory. Hallelujah. And he's got a new life awaiting him that he's never tasted before, and God's going to pour his mercy out upon him.
In case you're wondering if God's still alive, Steve, that's two this month we seen died that came back to life. I said that's two through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ that died upon the cross, that man can have life. Honey, you don't have to do it.
not only that, Wednesday night, Sister Harris's nephew, was it? Had a close call with death himself. But he's still alive today. And we're giving God the glory for that. In Jesus' name, we are going to win this war that Satan has put upon our people that we fall into. He may think he won, but he did not win. And I praise God today for these lives that are still alive today. And I thank God that God's going to show them and put his mercy upon them in Jesus' name. And we are here to help and be supportive of them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Yeah, buddy. Amen. That's church. Amen. Man, that's the God we serve. Amen. Amen. He holds the whole world in the palm of his hands. Amen. 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 Yeah, amen. Yeah, amen. Yeah, buddy, amen. All right. Amen, amen. Yeah. Yeah, amen. Don't you guys like the new platform? How nice and organized it is? Amen. We're fixing to add on. We're going to make that bigger in Jesus' name.
Yes.
They got new choir robes. They're looking fancy. Amen.
Yes. Amen. We are open for change. God is moving in a great and mighty way. We are growing in the Lord.
Yes.
And as we grow, there is change. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Amen.
The new TVs that we have up here, the monitors, they're not working today. But this is where your words will be at. Shortly, as soon as Glenn gets it going, he's working as hard as he can to get this together. I mean, they done a lot of work this week in this church, and it just takes time. Be patient with us because it's coming our way in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 It's getting better and better. Amen. Amen. Yeah. We get
first
there.
Donation. We're ready. We're ready.
Yeah, amen. Yeah, amen. All right. Amen. Yeah, amen.
We're getting ready. It's on its way, Janice.
Yeah. Amen.
Huh? Just put BF on it. Building fun.
Yeah, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. Amen.
It's on its way.
Amen. Soon and very soon. Amen.
Oh, it's anointed. I can't already talk.
You know, just let me testify for a second. Just for a second. Just for a second. I just want to brag on y'all for a minute. You know, I just want to tell you that you guys are the best congregation that a pastor could ever possibly imagine to be able to have the honor to pastor. Thank you guys very much. You guys are amazing. Now, I want to tell you what makes you amazing. Is that when all hell breaks loose, we know how to get a hold of God. That's what's amazing. We don't run to and fro with our heads cut off, wondering what's going to happen and what direction to go. We run to the altar of God and get down on our knees and expect God to do something. Amen. And I want to thank everybody that watches faithfully out there by live stream. We love you and we appreciate you and we thank you very much. We are here for your needs and we thank you. This congregation, give them a big victory temple. Welcome those that are faithful. Now give them a welcome. Give them a welcome. Hey. We consider ourselves a hospital church, in case you wonder, because if you're broken spirit, this is where you need to be. And if those that turn their back on you and you have nowhere to go, this is where you need to be. Because when you get to the hospital of God Almighty, everything turns around and everything is going to... But I also want to give some praise, for we have some folk in here to drive an hour every Sunday morning, 45 minutes to an hour, just to get to the house of God. I salute you. You are the best in Jesus' name.
Going on even back in the nursery back there. They got a bounce house back there. I see little heads bobbing back there. Bow, bow. Man, we got it going on. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. All right, but we have also the puppet plays coming up here soon. I don't know exactly the date on that. I think it's either this coming Wednesday or the following Wednesday. Following Wednesday. But they'll have puppet play practice tomorrow at 6 o'clock here at the church. So it's going to be an awesome time, amen? They're down in the ocean. They got seashells and boats and all kinds of stuff going on with it, amen?
And if you want to participate in one of these puppet shows, just get with Wendy.
Yeah.
She's open for help. She needs help. So.
Amen. The more the
merrier. If you're interested, get with her.
Yeah, amen. More
the merrier. Not this time because she's already got it planned out, but the next time.
Amen.
Wendy's good at volunteering you, so don't believe that.
She'll come to you. Amen. All right. We got one more. The teens did a funny face contest, and they had all kinds of crazy faces going on there. But the best one, the funniest face, the most likes and shares and everything was Caitlin. Come on up.
I didn't even know who she was.
Man. Yep. She won a $10 iTunes gift card, so... The teens are always having fun, amen? Amen. All right, I got a joke for you. It says, one day Adam was feeling very lonely. So God came down and said, Adam, I'm going to create this thing. It's called a woman for you. Adam said, okay, good deal. So God says, she'll cook for you. She'll clean for you. She won't nag you. She won't wake you up in the middle of the night. She'll bear your children. She'll always agree with you. And if you do have a disagreement, she'll be the first to come back and say, I'm sorry. God said, yeah, all right, well, how much is this going to cost? God said, an arm and a leg. So Adam said, all right, what can I get for a rib? Amen. The rest is history, amen.
I got a joke too. And I even printed it off so I wouldn't mess it up. It said two men was in a retirement center and they was talking. Norm said, I'm 85 years old and I feel like I'm falling apart. How do you feel, George? George replied, even though I'm almost 100, I feel like a newborn baby. How in the world can you feel like a newborn baby at your age? Norm asked. He said, well, I don't have any teeth. I don't have any hair. I can't sleep through the night, and I'm back to wearing a diaper.
Amen. Amen. Well, here's to getting old, amen.
Yeah, amen. Glory.
Amen. Well, if everybody stand, we'll bless the offering, amen. Thank you, Father God, for bringing us all back to church today. God, we thank you for the happiness and the joy in the atmosphere. God, we ask that you bless our pastor as he administers the word and bless the offering. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
He's an awesome God this morning. Well, listen up, let me tell everybody about my God who reigns. He can boast just a little bit about his holy name. He can turn the whole universe back, get up to fill my cup. Shout the Lord, sing along with me. Lift the praises up, you say. What is behind these are words I'm saying. What made me feel this way? He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He
is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
Listen right here. Well, just imagine just who he is and how his power flows. He healed the sick and he raised the dead, yeah. And from the grave he arose. He took the nails and he shed his blood to put us all back his way. And all the power that we need to live is by blessing Jesus' name. You say, what is behind these are words I'm saying that made me feel this way. He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
Yes, he is an awesome
God, 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 God.
Go ahead, give me some guitar this morning. Oh, he's so awesome this morning. What is behind these are what I'm saying. What made me feel this way? He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
He is an awesome
God, 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 God.
Somebody give God some praise in this house. Somebody praise him in here. Let's go out and praise him for a moment. Praise him in this house. Sometimes you gotta praise him although you don't know what's about to happen. Just praise him. Praise him. You know, we serve a good God.
Amen.
Look over at your neighbor before we get started this morning and say, I serve a good God.
I serve a good God.
Say, I serve a real good God. Say, I serve a real God. 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 Now give that God some praise in here, for he's real. gonna do things just a tad different this morning. I'm gonna give this choir about 3 minutes to go sit with your family. So if you get a second, go sit with your family this morning, because we have a family message that's about to be spoken here. And if you guys would, just follow me along this morning, for God's a good God. Amen. Too many times in life, we want to talk about the refreshing of life, but we really don't want to talk about how we come to the point to get refreshed. See, there's one thing that we can come into life and say that we're refreshed, and then we claim that we're refreshed, and then we walk around and we pray that we refresh. But when it comes down to the rubber meeting the road, there's some things you got to do in your life so that God can refresh you. And the problem is, we don't want to put the action behind what we got to do so that we can be set free. Honey, you just don't become set free. You got to put some action behind what you got so that you become free. In order to be refreshed, refreshing meaning this morning, new ideas, refreshed in the mind. In order to be refreshed, you have to have a new mind.
Come on, Pastor.
I lost everybody in the beginning, but the three that I have followed me. You gotta have a new mind.
Come on. That's right.
Now wait a minute. Now wait a minute. If you don't want what God's got to offer, just sit there and look at the floor and laugh. But if you want something new in your life, you better turn your spiritual ears on. Get your ears up out of the darkness and begin to listen. Hold on. I'm going to start this morning with a story, and then we're going to get into the word. It said, in a small rural community, there are a lot of cattle ranchers. And every once in a while, a cow wanders off and gets lost. So they asked the rancher, how can a cow get lost? How does that happen? And the rancher replied, well, the cow starts nibbling on one turf of grass. And when he finishes, he looks ahead to the next turf of grass. And he starts nibbling on that one. And then when he nibbles on that one enough, he sees another one that's got a hole next to the fence. And so then he goes to the fence and nibbles on that turf of grass. And then after that turf of grass is gone, he crosses over the fence to the next thing. And the next thing that he knows, he is lost because of what he's been nibbling on. Is it possibility that the church is lost today because of what they have been nibbling on? We ain't been looking for God. We've been looking for what we can get in our spiritual mouth. Instead of looking at what God has got to say, we've been looking at what man's got to say. And so instead of pleasing God, we begin to please flesh. And when we begin to please flesh, we forget about the power that God has. I serve a powerful God. I serve a real God.
Come on.
Hit me with this a little bit more monitor, if you would. Is it possible that we have forgot the morals of Jesus Christ?
Yeah, come on.
Is it possible that we no longer get set free, but we use a cover-up?
Yeah. Come on, Pastor.
Yeah, we're going to walk this morning. I can see the faces. But in order to get set free, you can't have a cover-up in your life. You can't be looking for the next big thing. You got to know that you are the next big thing. Come hell or high water, I am going to succeed. In order to get there, you have to have a change of mind. You got to know the grass is not greener on the other side. And you got to know that next piece of grass ain't worth what you're thinking about. Somebody thinks I'm talking about dope. Maybe I am. Honey, I want to tell you something. You got to set it down and walk away from it. Because if you don't do the setting, God can't do. Hold on, we're going to smile in a minute.
but we're going to go all the way back to your roots. Nobody wants to get rid of the roots. We just want to put some makeup on this flesh that God gave us and call us that we're beautiful. But the truth is, when we take the makeup off, are you really as beautiful as you seem?
Come on.
Let me bring it home like this. You act like you nice in front of me, but how do you treat your husband when you get home? You act like you got a relationship with God in the church house, but how's your relationship when you get home with God that afternoon? Do you still praise him when you ain't got nothing? Do you still praise him when all hell is breaking loose? How do you...
Come on, Pastor.
I'm tired of not succeeding in life. Tired of seeing my family not succeed in life. Tired of putting 1 foot forward and a month later I put 2 foot back. Why am I keep going back and not forward? You got to have a change of mind. You cannot serve Christ unless you have a change of mind. You gotta know that Christ loves you. He is for you. He is not against you. And until you change your mind on the outlook of your life will keep going in the rut that it's in. Honey, if you think you're sick all the time, you're going to be sick all the time. You got to change your outcome by your... We have a lot of folk that claim it and they name it, but they think naming and claiming it is painting it.
Come on, say that.
I have a poor attitude, so I'm going to change it. I'm just going to paint it.
Come on.
I got bitterness in my life, but instead of changing it, I'm just going to paint it, touch it up a little bit. I got a little bit of a lustful eye in my head, but instead of changing it, I'll just paint it a little bit, and maybe my wife won't notice it. I am totally unhappy in life, but I'm just going to paint it. But the fact is, you never got rid of it. You just painted it. So when your days begin to go back, you go back to what you painted because it's still there. Honey, I don't want to paint my problems. I want to get rid of my problems. And how do I get rid of my problems? It's by changing my mind and the outcome of my problem.
Hey, come on.
Tired of seeing people living like an angel in front of me.
Come on, say that.
And being a little devil when they're away.
Come on. Preach.
But God used me in a sermon. God also used a donkey. Preach, Pastor. Tell me the truth. God used me. He also used the whale. He said, no. He said, you be here at 10 o'clock when they throw him overboard. But the water is different from me. He said, I don't care. I'm going to use you to get Jonah where I need to be. Just because God used you don't make you no more anointed than the man on the moon. Honey, you got to have a change of mind that changes your spirit, that changes your heart.
Amen.
You're gonna punch me because I'm gonna punch back. Matthew. Oh, wait a minute. I see some. I can read you like a book.
Come on.
You're sitting in that chair and you said, maybe I don't want to change. That's your choice, but quit bringing your hell to me.
Right. Come on, say that. Hey! That's right.
don't want to change. I like what I got painted. Then quit taking your problems with God and enjoy what God allowed to have in your life. But for me and my house, we are going to serve the Lord. I don't want your hell in my house.
Amen. Good word. Come on.
For my house has been refreshed. Matthew 9:17. And it reads like this. Neither do men put new wine into an old bottle, unless the bottle break and the wine runneth out and the bottle perishes. Well, we don't want to talk about that perish.
Come on.
But the bottle perish. But they that put new wine in the new bottles, and both are preserved. You know why you sit there and you say, I heard this before? Because you're an old bottle that ain't never got to become new. You're still trying to patch what God gave you. Honey, I ain't got to patch my old life. My old life is dead. No longer to be, no longer to walk in. I am a new creation underneath Jesus Christ. I ain't got no old life. I walk into a new life with a new vessel and a new bottle.
Hey.
Let me explain to you what the scripture means, and then maybe you'll understand a little bit more. The scripture simply means this, that you cannot take an old skin and put a new skin over a hole, because the new skin don't know how to stretch. The new skin is new, and the new skin will not expand. So what we do in life, instead of letting God change our mind, we try to put a patch over the situation. Well, honey, the patch cannot overcome your situation, because the new patch don't understand the old ways. So when the old ways wants to stretch and bust, the new...
Come on.
So instead of laying the old flesh down in our family, we tried to patch the old flesh in our family.
Come on, Pastor.
How do I do that? You have a lying problem, but you say, well, I didn't lie on Monday.
Come on.
It's impossible to get rid of something that you like.
Come on, Pastor. That's right. Good word.
It's totally impossible to like what you hate. Now, are you ready to go somewhere?
Yeah, come on.
We say that we have unforgiveness in our heart, but we forgave. Have you really forgave? Because unforgiveness is a choice. You got to pick to be unforgiven. You got to pick to be hateful. You got to pick to be a hypocrite. You got to pick to be down and out. You have to choose in your life. That is a choice that you have to make. But honey, I'm in here to tell you, in the new bottle and in the new wineskin, there is no unforgiveness. I know, we all pray, Lord, make me good, but not yet. Lord, make me good, but not entirely. Lord, just make me good. There's no such thing as a halfway mind with Christ. How can you truly be forgiven when your mind says you're not?
Come on, say that.
How can you truly be delivered when your mind says you're not? How can you truly be healed when your mind says you're not? I got some folk in here that was easy. And when Big Bad Boo Boo come up and said, baby, you look hot, you was easy. But we about to get a change of mind in here, that when he walks up and says, I'm not easy no more, I am better than that. For I ain't looking for your approval, I am looking for God's approval.
Come on.
Esau had a problem. Esau come in from hunting. He was a man's man, drove an F-250. Four-wheel drive, had a Harley Davis parked in his garage. He kept the old 68 Fatback, you know what I'm saying? Fat boy, you know what he was a man's man. Wore American flag on the back of his coat. He was a man's man.
Come on.
Picked up trees and throwed them for fun. He was a man's man. Sit down at night, drunk a 12-pack of Pepsi, ate a bag of Doritos, and didn't think nothing about it. He was a man's man. He didn't care what kind of waist he had. He was just a man's man. I'm a man.
Come on. That's right.
Some men on here, I say, hey, man, brother, preach it on.
Come on.
Somebody said, did you really eat a whole bag of Doritos? Yes, I did, and I enjoyed every one of them. I made a choice, and I enjoyed it. He was a man's man. Come in from hunting with his bow, set it down in a corner. Hungry as he could be. His brother looked across the table and said, you hungry? He said, I hungry. He said, can I have some of that? He said, if you give me your birthrights. The problem with that story is that he made a permanent decision over something that was temporary. Because this hunger shall pass. This sickness shall pass. This failure should pass. This day shall pass. I ain't making a permanent decision over something that shall pass. This trouble that you are in, it shall pass. Why give up 30 years of your life on something that's only going to last for 24 hours? You got to quit making permanent decisions over things that don't last.
Amen.
It was in his mind.
Come on.
Now wait a minute. I'm getting ready to throw a rock in the pond. For everybody says Jacob tricked him. Esau. I don't read it that way.
Yeah, come on.
I read it that Esau was stupid.
Amen.
I read it that he was stupid. For if you bought a brand new Harley Davidson and pulled it in this church and I offered you that glass of water for it and you took it, you're stupid. I didn't trick you. You chose to do it. You're stupid.
Amen.
Maybe I'm the only one that went to the edge of my bedroom, sat down on the bed and said, why did I do such a stupid thing? Stupid, 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 stupid. Why did I make such a stupid decision? You gotta come to the point in your life that you quit making the dumb decisions that Satan wants you to make in your life. Honey, if you'll figure it out, it shall pass. 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 Somebody give God some praise in it.
Go ahead.
Hey. Hey. Stupid decisions. You know the one that you broke up with your boyfriend, you swear you'll never go out with nobody like him again, and 2 days later you find yourself with somebody that just uses you the same way that your other one did? That was a stupid decision. Honey, you gotta make up in your mind that I no longer have stupid decisions in my life. I see the outcome. I know what that outcome was. I did not like that outcome. And for me and my house, we're gonna try something different. We're gonna try serving the Lord. We're gonna try letting him make my decisions.
Come on, go ahead.
Your word.
It's all in the decisions that you make.
Come on.
Just because you look like an angel, don't make you an angel.
Come on, say that. That's right.
Hey, let me come down and straighten your halo up on top of your horns. But until you decide that you hate that spirit is going to stay with you. So why do I fight the same spirit over and over and over? Why am I always in debt for the stupid decisions that we made? Quit making a dumb decision. If you can't afford it, don't buy it. And if you can't get it, don't worry about it.
Come on. That's right.
We just keep it real in here. Hold on. You know what the problem is we have in life is that if we want it, we buy it. If we need it, we beg for it.
Come on. Say that.
And if we want sex, we just go to bed with whoever.
Come on. That's right.
Lost you on that, didn't I? We seem like it comes out no matter what our flesh calls for. We go after what our flesh wants. Why don't we try going after what our spirit wants? Why don't we try to go after a change of life and a happiness and a joy and a peace that cannot be found here on this earth? Why don't we go after the good thing? We can't find it, we just buy it.
Come on.
You can't buy salvation. And you can't buy a change of mind.
Come on. Hallelujah.
You'll never be set free from the addiction in your life until you realize that you are a new wineskin, that you can contain what God's got for you. Why ain't my life being blessed? God cannot pour into an old vessel that's been patched up because he ain't dumb. He'll just be wasting what he has. And I serve a God that is not wasteful. If you want your cup to runneth over, you gotta get a new wineskin, and it's free. All you gotta say is, Jesus, save my soul. And the day I have a changed mind, that I can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens me. Satan, get off my back. Get off my family. Get off my finances. Get off my joy. Get off my peace. Today I am new. 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 Somebody to say, Satan, get off of me. Satan, get off of me. Give him some praise. It's 12 o'clock. It's 60 degrees outside. We all ready to crank up our Harleys and put on a barbecue. But I got a warning on that before we go back into it. I'm going to finish when I started. But I got a warning on that. For the written word of God said that when the changing of seasons appear, you better look close to heaven because God is about to send his son back. Honey, you better get a change of mind for your God is about to send his son back. Prodigal son went out and done his own thing. But the written word of God said that when the prodigal son come to his senses.
Come on now.
Said when he come to his senses. When you come to your senses and realize you don't have to live the way you've been thinking you gotta live. The hog pen won't hold you back. The clothes on your back won't hold you back. What your friends deserted you won't hold you back. Though you're broke, it won't hold you back. Though they say you can't, it won't hold you back. Though that you stink, it can't hold you back. Though that you make dumb decisions, can't hold you back. I'm on the road to my father. Do I got anybody in here that's on the road to their father? If you're on the road to your father, why don't you stand and give your father some praise in here for what he has done in your life. Nothing can hold you back. A divorce can't hold you back. Lies can't hold you back. Stress can't hold you back. Backstabbing can't hold you back. Oh my God, a hypocrite can't hold you back. Opinion can't hold you back. A bad deal can't hold you back. Sickness can't hold you back. A bad report can't hold you back. Nothing can hold you back when you have a change of mind through Jesus Christ. Do you have that change of mind? Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him.
Lord, we praise you, Lord.
You know why I praise him? You ready? Because I know that everything is going to be all right. I know that this is just temporary. And I done got up out of the hog pen. And I know that everything is going to be all right. I said, I know that everything is going to be all right. I know. Chad, take it.
Put your hands together this morning. Sing this chorus.
Well, I got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Whoa, 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 I
do you have a feeling in this moment?
Everything's gonna be alright. Whoa, whoa, I got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright.
Can you sing that chorus? I got a feeling.
Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright.
When Moses was on the backside of the desert and God called him out and he had to go set God's people free. Could you imagine what he was thinking? I know that everything is going to be all right. Oh my God. And when David was called out to kill the giant with a slingshot and a rock, could you imagine what he thought when he went to that battlefield? He said, I know that everything is going to be all right. When the Hebrew boys went to the furnace, he said, I don't know if my God will, but my God is able. Your God is able in here this morning, and give him a shout of victory.
If you're in this house this morning and you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, all you gotta do is call out on the name of Jesus. If you'll say, Jesus, Jesus, I repent in Jesus' name. You just as saved as you could possibly be. Give God a shout. Give him a shout.
I've got a feeling, say, everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling, everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling, everything's gonna be alright. Be alright, be alright, be alright. Go ahead, guitar, play it out. Come on, drums.
Come on, praise him. Praise him. Praise him. It's going to be all right. Praise him in him. Praise him in him. For we have victory in his house this morning. This is victory, but play, can't play.
Singing that church, I got a feeling, I've got a feeling, everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling, everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling, everything's gonna be alright. Be alright, be alright, be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Morning.
Well, if it's all right this morning, can you say? Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Sing, children. I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Ooh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Ooh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Said the Holy Ghost done told me. Well, the Holy Ghost done told me everything's gonna be alright. Said the Holy Ghost done told me everything's gonna be alright. Well, the Holy Ghost done told me everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Well, sing it, church. Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Be all right. Can you sing that this morning? Well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Say, well, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Be alright. Be alright. Be alright. A little boy named David went out to fight the giant. Everyone laughed at such a funny little sight. A little shepherd boy armed with only a sling beside mighty Goliath like a puny little thing. But David said, you come to me with a spear and a sword, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. Said he put a little stone in that sling, and when it left his hands, David in the scene said, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Oh, I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Be alright.
alright. Be alright.
Everything is gonna be alright. Somebody shout, it's alright in here. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright.
I have a word for someone in here. I have a word for you. Someone in here has been waiting on something, and they've been waiting on it very patiently. Don't wax yourself short and give yourself the short end of the stick, because God's got something really good in store for you. Don't settle for second best. Settle only for the best. That's how much your God loves you. Be patient, be still, and know God is God. Oh, Lord, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody just say, Jesus, I love you. Say, Jesus, 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 I love you. Before we go, let's sing, oh, how we love Jesus.
Sing it together, family. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. Oh, how I love him this morning, say. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh,
oh, how we love him, church.
Oh, how we love Jesus. Oh, how we love Jesus. Oh, so wonderful to me, he is so wonderful to me.
He just lift your hands towards heaven,
so
and give him a praise. Just lift your hands towards heaven and Come on, lift your hands. He is so worthy to be praised. That's the greatest thing you can do to God. To give Him your praise. Give Him your life and give Him your praise. Just praise Him.
Oh, how we love Him this morning.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
How we thank you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus. Jesus, I thank you. Oh, I love you, Jesus.
How we love Jesus. Oh, how we love Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for what you've done in this house this morning. God, we thank you that all things are possible through Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you that we are free, that our mind is free, that we have been refreshed in here this morning. God, we thank you, God, that we know everything is going to be all right. God, we know that this shall pass. God, we know. God, we put all our trust in you. And God, I ask you to bless this congregation from the storehouses of heaven. And the congregation of Victory Temple says, amen. I love you. I'll see you Wednesday night.
Praise you. Oh Lord my God, in you I put my trust. Oh Lord my God, in you I put my hope. Oh Lord my God, in you I put my trust. Oh Lord my God, in you I put my hope. If you say, in you I find my peace. In you I find my strength. In you I live and move and breathe.